morning, gang. It's Thursday, the 12th of January, 2017. And I'm running very late this morning, actually. Normally, I'd get... I mean, I know it's like 5 to 11 where you... If you're watching the show, it's live if it's 5 to 11 in the morning or just coming up to 5 to 11 in the morning on Thursday, the 12th of January, 2017. If it's any other time, you're watching a recording, which is just as good, but not live. Not quite dead, fortunately. But not live either, no. So I've got up a little bit later than I usually do. I didn't sleep well at all again last night. This has been happening for a few days now. I'm not quite sure why that is. You know, sort of laying it. Not uncomfortable. I'm not, you know, those bits where you can't sleep and you really don't feel comfortable. Oh, you're going to have to get up. Maybe you have a cup of tea. Actually, that often helps if I have a cup of tea and then go back to bed again. But I stayed in bed and eventually I woke up a little later than usual, around about 9:30, actually, which is probably very late for you if you're an early getter-upper, so to speak. But I like to be up around about 8:15, 9:15 in the morning. I have things to do. We can't spend all day laying in bed. So, looking at my clock, and then I tried to ring my mate to see if he wanted to come swimming, but he wasn't answering the phone. So I thought, where I go up the swimming pool, the place I go to, they have water aerobics. And I think today's water aerobics are... I always get it wrong. But I think today's water aerobics are like 11:30 to 12:30, or maybe 12 till 1. So as you can see, it's 5 to 11. By the time I get up there, it would be about 11:30, by which time they're started, or I've only got 30 minutes. So I thought I'd come and have a bit of a morning show and a little chat at you this morning. Good morning. I hope you're well today. Let's say hello to the early people who are with us today. Oh, quite a few. I'm surprised, actually. It's interesting to see that the same people that are with us late at night are here in the morning as well. How strange and mysterious is that? Strange and mysterious, yes. We want to say hello to a few people. Also, I've got a shout. Oh, it's actually there, isn't it? Got to say hello to Timothy Thomas this morning, who's off to a funeral. Hello, Tim. Nice to see you, sir. Tim, whose other half is Kerry. And they're going to Camp David's funeral this morning. So, best wishes for you there. Both of you, and of course to Camp David. Camp David, sorry, you're over there, aren't you? I've moved the cameras around a little bit. I'll tell you in a minute. Camp David was someone, a long, long time regular at the Black Cap, which, as you well know, I worked for a lot. 18 years I was there, and he was there kind of at the beginning. He was certainly there when I joined in. And I always remember him saying he came up to the DJ box. I think it was a Thursday and a Friday. I had an audition for this place. This would be 1989. Yes, 1989. I had an audition there. And on the Thursday, he came up and it wasn't over busy on a Thursday. It was okay. It certainly wasn't empty like it has been. So, you know, over the years before it closed down again. He said, oh, you make sure you wear a pair of shorts here on a Friday because it gets so hot. I didn't know, actually, whether he meant it actually got hot or he just wanted to see my legs, which I think... which I think is more likely, don't you, Tim? Oh, good old Camp David. I haven't seen him for God knows how many years, but we lost him about a couple of weeks ago now. So I hope the funeral goes all right. And you know what Camp David was like, full of flair and all that. He wouldn't want to see you all sitting there crying. So do something outrageous, you know. Stand up and start singing. Change the words. If he's got hymns, I don't know if he'd have hymns or not. Change the words to one of the hymns. That's what you want to do, Tim. All right. I hope it goes okay for you. Thank you, Tim. And I hope that was okay. All right. Good morning to Joey Millen, who joins us this morning. Morning, Joey. Carl. Good morning, Carl. Am I a breakfast show for anyone this morning? Are we a breakfast show without music? I mean, I can do music if you want me to. I can sing to my heart's content if you require that. Send your requests in now. George Roberts, good morning, George. Rod Brown, you're always there, aren't you, Rod? Morning, Rod. Danny Davis is there, who we had a 45-minute chat with the other night, didn't we? George Roberts, I've said that. Hello, Chris. I'm very well, thank you. And Kiki D says, you're not looking at us. I should be looking at you now, my darling. Am I looking at you now? I was looking on the wrong side, weren't I? I tell you what I've done. I noticed that I did have one camera on top of the other, the top one being the live one, and the one underneath was the recorded one. And I noticed, because I once the live ones, once the live show is finished, I then cancel that particular recording because it never looks very good. I don't know why. It looks okay while you're live, but when you look at the recording of the live camera, the lip is completely out of sequence with the picture. I don't know why that is. I've tried all sorts of things to sort that. But I think we're going to have to get Ben Parker around here to sort it out. Ben Parker is a computer expert. So what I've done now is put the two cameras next to each other. So I hope that looks better now. So I've actually, it's one there, and they're very close together, sort of the lenses. So hopefully that'll sort that out. All right, Kiki, we can't be looking at, because if I look over there, you see that's where the camera was before, over there. And I must now remember to look to the right, to hang to the right. Sorry, to look to the right. Yes. I'm certainly not wearing tracksuit bottoms, so you can see that. Good morning to Constantine, who says, Happy New Year. Happy New Year to you as well, darling. Happy New Year. You haven't been to my karaoke lately, have you? In your lovely red outfit, which is very nice. Good morning to Callum, who's with us this morning as well. Everyone's there. That's nice to see. Kiki D says, it's okay if you watch it live on YouTube afterwards. Ah, yes, but that's not live then, is it? That's a recording. You're watching a recording after it finishes live. At the moment, we are live. If it's like 11 o'clock in the morning, we are live. If it's any other time, you're now watching a recording. But it comes down and there's a bit of a gap. As soon as I finish the live, it doesn't immediately go back up. I have to save something on the other camera, save the film on the other camera, whatever you call it, film, I don't know, and then re-upload it so it gets in much better quality. We can't be having low quality programmes here, dear. Good God, no, I don't think so. Wendy says, you must have needed the sleep yesterday. Well, quite possibly, yeah, because I didn't sleep too well. Don't know why that is. Kiki D says, I'm not stupid. I know that, dear. Who said you were? Who said you were stupid? Kiki D. Everyone always asks me, Kiki D, are you Kiki D? I said, yes, she's Kiki D, unless I know the Kiki D. I said, of course she's the Kiki D. What, the one who sailed with Elton John? And then they say, I say, no, she didn't sing with Elton John. Well, she's not the Kiki D. I said, she is the Kiki D, if you don't mind me saying so. Yes, yes. Anyway, listen to this. So, a bit quiet at the quiz last night, but a nice night. Nice people in there. Lovely people. We had five teams. which became four teams, unfortunately. Oh, dear. Someone was caught cheating. Can we all have a big tap, please? Some naughty people were caught cheating. Tut, 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 tut. Which is a shame, really, because they were doing so well. Mind you, they might have been doing well because they because they were cheating in the first round. I caught them cheating in the second round. Okay? So I have a few rules, just two rules, really, when I'm doing my quiz nights. Rule number one is no using mobile phones, laptops, iPads, tablets, anything like that while the quiz is going on. We don't have any of that, right? And rule number two is please don't ask questions about the questions, because what you get is people who overanalyze things. And it could be, I'm just trying to think of an example now. What colour, and you can see one here behind me as displayed here in the Mirrorball studio, which is actually perked up a bit. Have you noticed that? Dead leaf, oh dear. But it's going bad from the bottom upwards, which is a bit like, you know, men's feet, isn't it? You know when you're a teenager, lads, and your feet really stink? Well, that's good news because your bottom bits, your feet, are going off first. So by the time it gets to your brain, you're hundreds of years old. Anyway, so the poinsettia, the question could be, okay? The question could be, what colours are a poinsettia? Right? That could be the question. And then someone who overanalyzes the question could say, what time of the year do you mean? Do you mean December? Do you mean April? And does that mean it's been put in a cupboard for a while or not? No, you're overanalyzing the question. Generally, what colours are poinsettias? And they are green and red, correct? A Of course, dear. Of course. Sometimes you get pink and green as well. I would accept pink and green. But they overanalyse the questions, you see. So that's why we have that rule. Please don't ask questions about the questions. Otherwise, an immediate 5-point deduction. Ding, 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 ding. 5-point deduction for that. Thank you very much. And sometimes they say, oh, can I just ask, you know, number five is that, and then I quickly say on the microphone, are you asking a question about the questions? Because there is an immediate 5-point deduction. Oh, no, no, it's OK. It's OK. That shuts them up immediately. You see, we can't, because if people keep doing that, you just can't move on. It goes on and on. And then if you do it once, they start asking, you know, it's the old saying, you give them an inch, give them an inch, and they take a mile. That's what happens. Right? So they're really the only two rules. So I'm walking around doing round one, reading out my questions, collected the things in, and actually I don't tell people where they are, the position that they're winning or losing in, until the very end. Because, again, what can happen there is that if they're doing badly, they just go. And you want them to join in the fun. And more importantly, spend more money on beer. Keeps me in a job, dear. It does. So we did the round one and they were winning. They were actually ahead, 1 point ahead of everyone else. The rule about the mobile phones is don't use your mobile phones. If I see you using a mobile phone, first of all, by the time I've told you I can see you using a mobile phone, I would have been standing behind you for a couple of minutes. Believe me. And they don't notice. This is the old thing about walking across the road with your mobile phone. You just don't notice. I mean, how many people are now dead because the stupidity of them has them on the mobile phone crossing the roads either on or off a zebra crossing? Makes no difference. On or off a zebra crossing. Right? So, if I see you using your mobile phone, I'll ask to look at the screen. If you turn it off quickly or shove it under the table, we will assume you're cheating, whether I see it or not, and you will be taken out of that round. You will not be barred from the pub. You will not be barred from the quiz, but you will lose a possible 10 points by being taken out of that round. Everyone agree? Yes, and everyone says yes. So that's it. So round two's going on. There's a table where there's two girls sitting there and a boy. The girls are a bit mouthy. And the boy's sitting there fairly quiet, but he's quite pleasant towards me, okay? So I'm walking around, I spot him with the mobile phone. And it's under the... it's so obvious. I mean, how stupid are these people that they don't think anyone can see them doing it? I mean, it's a bloody joke, it really is. And it's like, say this is a mobile phone. Right, so it's under there like this, and they're like this. Right. They keep it under the table and tap, tap, tapping away. Tap. So I've stood behind him and the two girls. That, I mean, the other thing is, right, so I'm standing behind him. He's got a girl here and a girl, and they, none of them saw me. None of them saw me. All right? Have you got your mobile phone on? Quickly under the table. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Oh, and then... He never said anything. Of course, the girls immediately jumped to the defence. Oh, he wasn't cheating. No, we wouldn't do such a thing like... Oh, I'm very sorry. And I got my pen. I got my pen and I went... Shh, shh, I'm sorry, you're out of that word. Oh, please, we weren't cheating. We weren't cheating. No, I'm afraid that's the rules. And then they try... They try and start creating an argument. So you're saying we're cheating, are you? I said, I don't know, but the rule is you must show me your mobile phone. Oh, it was just texting his girlfriend. Oh, we wouldn't cheat like that. Because we were doing so well. Of course you were doing so well because you were cheating, love. But I didn't say that. And it went on and on. And eventually, and it's always the same. It's the same with these girls who come up too late at karaoke and some of the boys. But I have to say, I'm sorry, ladies, mainly the young girls, not the older ones, the young girls. They come up to you and they say, oh, can I put in a carrot? Oh, sorry, we're full up now. Oh, please, can I put one? I'm really sorry, we're full up now. Well, can't you take someone else out and put me in? No, I can't, that's not fair. Well, no one will know. And it's like that. It was just like that with the quiz. And eventually... They know I'm not going to back down. And then they turn on you. And then they turn on you. And just like a silly little girl, it's like, right, I'm not coming to do this quiz anymore. She's like that. How pathetic. How pathetic. The reason there's a rules like that is because we got to be fair to everyone. It's not fair. Why can't you see that? It's not fair. And the one thing I'm known for in competitions, well, I don't like to do competitions, but quiz nights, I want to be fair to every single person. Everyone should have the same chance. They really should. So that was the little cheating ones that we wheedled out last night. And I think they stayed for a little bit longer than they went because they couldn't win after that. You know, if you've lost 10 points in a round, you're quite welcome to stay for the fun afterwards. But you can't win. It's not fair on other people, is it? And, you know, really, really, I'll let you into this secret. Really, what you want to do when you catch someone cheating... what you want to do when you catch someone cheating is to drag them outside and beat them. You know, beat them with a stick. And not only that, and film it and do it in front of the window so that all the other contestants can see what's happening to this person. And then they won't cheat anymore. That's what we need. More capital punishment, dear. People need to be caned in schools. Beat them. Beat them. How dare you cheat at my quiz? Beat them. Beat them like that. Beat them. Yes. And then call an ambulance, see them being carted away, and then walk back in and carry on. Carry on quietly with the quiz. I bet there wouldn't be any more trouble after that, would there? Oh, dear. A few messages coming in. Callum says, when I was at karaoke, I was very patient waiting for my songs. You were a patient person, Callum. Hello to non-Irish Mary from Ireland is with us this morning, who says, rules is rules. And she said, this is a lovely jacket. Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much. This is actually a Burton's one. This is the cheapest jacket out of all of them. Look, it's a Burton's one. Look at that. Can you see the label there? I don't know if you can see. No, you can't. There is no label. Is it? Oh, is there one? Right at the top there. I can't know if it's a... This is a Burton's jacket. It's about a year and a half old or something like that, Mary. Danny Davis says, is a repeat of questions allowed? Yes. I do read the questions twice. Anyway, sort of, you know, how many numbers in the... I don't know. What is 10 times 10? And I say, what is 10 times 10? And then sometimes, oh, could you say that again, please? The only reason they say that again, because they were too busy having a conversation, dear. People aren't paying attention. Are you paying attention this morning? I do hope so. People aren't paying attention. So, yes, repeat your questions. Could you repeat that, please? Yes, no problem at all. So I do repeat the questions. Thank you. Blue and pink Constantine says, are very cheerful. Yeah, I thought I was selecting. I was in my cupboard of many jackets and many shirts, selecting something bright and cheery for a morning show. You know, we can't be wearing sort of dark colours at this time of day, I don't think. Hopefully soon, Constantine says, I will see you. I do hope so. You are Mr. Ad Karaoke. And perhaps one day you will sing for us as well, my darling. That would be quite nice, wouldn't it? Good morning to Kevin Webster, who says, hiya, Chris. Hello, Kevin. Kiki D says, just kill them. Oh, I think you're going a bit far there, Kiki D. Just a good beating. Well, they need to be beaten in full view of everyone in the pub. And on, oh, I would film it, of course, for this very programme. Yes, I would do that as well. All right, going back to the quiz. So that was nice. Interestingly, people are not actually one of the bar staff. My very, very good friend Charlie was not paying full attention last night. And right at the end, we actually had a tiebreaker last night. And the question was, when was the first UK mobile telephone call made? And I think I can't remember the blooming answer now. First mobile call, first UK mobile call, if I remember, here it is, 1985. So it's how many years ago is that? 85, 95, 05, 15, 16, 17. So it's 32 years? 32 years. I don't actually have the question here, but it was, when did a name make the very first UK mobile phone to a name on the Vodafone network? And the answer is, I've got the answer here, 30... I think it's 31 years now. What's that? 15, 16, 17. Yeah, I'm sure it's 31 years or something like that. Anyway, so one team wrote down 31 years. And the bar staff team wrote down something like 54 years. Anyway, so the thing came, so I gave the point to them. And then the barman's come running over to me. Oh, you've got that wrong. Oh, have I? Yeah, yeah, look, look. And he flashed up this little Google. Because a lot of people are Googling the answers, which kind of takes the fun away from it a little while sometimes, I think. But there we are. And it said 54 years. And so I thought, oh, I've got this wrong now. I said, well, I can't change it now. I've now told them that they've won the prize, which is only a £30 bar tab. It's not a massive prize, is it? A 30 quid bar tab. But nevertheless, I've told him. He said, I know, that's OK. But then later on, he came back and says, oh, I've checked again. Actually, did you say UK phone? I said, yes, I did. He said, ah, well, that is indeed 31 years or whatever it was. So sometimes, and the trouble with Googling answers is that you can probably find your answer in that Google. This is the problem with Googling everything. It's not always right. I tell you what isn't always right. You can't always rely on that Wikipedia either, because so many people can edit the thing, can't they? You know, if you register, you can do an edit to it. I mean, it could say, I don't know, that the Queen has been lying about her ages and now is fit. And people would believe that. Then this is the problem with Googling the answers. Anyway, so we sorted that out. We got a winner, and that was all well and good. They won by just 1 point, 42 points out of 50. That's not bad, is it, for a quiz night? 42 points out of 50. It came to wages time, and they paid me my wages. I said, and there's another £10 for you. I said, well, what's that for? Well, we have had a little discussion upstairs. And as it's a new year, we thought you'd give you an extra £10. How nice is that? How lovely is that? I didn't even ask. If only managers all over the place were a bit more like that, a bit more appreciative, not just to me, but to other people and things that they do. But, you know, so many of them are, oh, pay out as least as possible and get as much in for myself. So many of them are like that. Not this one isn't like that at all. And I feel, it's not the £10, you see. You feel very, very appreciative when something like that happens. So that was really nice. Funnily enough, the old manager was there as well last night, who I haven't seen for some time. Tom, his name was, and he was telling me once the quiz had got going, and it's coming up to 2 years now, actually, I've been there. Once the quiz, although the traffic can be a nightmare, okay with the traffic last night, that wasn't too bad. An hour and 40 minutes, which is about the limit of my sanity. An hour and 40 minutes I can do and I haven't gone insane. So that's okay, actually. But Tom, who was the old manager there, told me once the quiz had started going, they actually had to buy in more chairs and tables to cope with it. And I did not know that. I did not know that. So that's good, isn't it? So it works all around, isn't it? As you know, what I do, I like to be paid a fair amount. And I was already being paid a fair amount there. But in my mind, what I think for the job, a lot of people who do my sort of thing, whether it's karaoke, quiz nights, DJ, they tell me I don't charge too much. They tell me I don't charge enough, rather. But I'm happy with what I get. So that's it. And remember, I've told you so many times, what I do is not for the money. I expect to be paid, if it's a reasonable night, a reasonable amount, you know, a decent amount. But I never came into this to make loads of money. I've done very well, but I never came into it to make loads of money, and I'm still not in it to make loads of money, all right? So just want to say that, and I really appreciate that extra £10 there. So that was that, and that should be the end of the night, really. So I always go round and say thank you to people for playing. Strangely enough, our regular team last night, the Short Planks, were not there. Now, they have been every single week in one form or another, whether there's only a couple of them or a few or eight of them, depending on, you know, whether they're all free. They've always been. Last night, they weren't there, so I don't know where the Short Planks were last night. Anyway, that's not the most important part of the night, not the quiz. So later on, I went into my bag, got my car keys, couldn't find my house keys. And I thought, I'm sure I put them in here. And then I closed my eyes. Oh, I didn't close my eyes. I thought about it. And absolutely, those keys should be in my bag because I put them. I always put my car keys and my home keys, and they're on two different rings, you see, back into the same place in my bag. Couldn't find these damn things anywhere. And I am searching everywhere. I've gone in the other bags. And I've searched this bag four times now. Charlie came over from behind the bar. And, oh, you'd like him, girls. Charlie. You, ladies, you would love Charlie. He's about 21, 22. Strangely enough, he says he's like nearly the same weight as me. And yet he doesn't look like me. He hasn't got this stomach here. And he's about the same height as me. Maybe a little bit taller, ladies. But you'd like him, ladies. You'd like Charlie, okay? And he's looking now. We've looked under the stage and behind the stage and in front of the stage. And I thought, well, when I went to the toilet earlier, when I first came in, I remember feeling a weight in the back of my jeans. And that, and I put my hand in the back of my jeans, and it was my home keys, which I must have put in there at some moment. So I took them out of there and put them in my bag. I know I did, in this pocket, and I could not find them. So I've taken my stuff out to the car. I've had a good look in the car. I can't find my home keys in the car as well. So I went back to the pub again, had another look around the stage. No sign of these keys. I've emptied the computer bag again. When I say emptied it, you know, put my hand in, because you can feel a bunch of keys, can't you? I've emptied a couple of the pockets. They're not in the pockets. I've taken the computer out. They're not underneath the computer. Again, back to the car, looking in the car again. Can't find them. Well, fortunately, my mate has a spare set of my keys. So I start ringing him. Of course, he's not answering. It's about 10 to 11 now at night. Usually I'm in the car by about 22. So I spent some time looking for these things. I rang his house phone, I rang his home phone, house phone, mobile phone, and I kept alternating between the two. I rang his boyfriend a couple of times, no answer. I thought, oh, I'm on my way home now, so I'm on the hands-free thing. And I thought, oh, and I had visions. I had visions of me sitting in the car and actually, I wouldn't have done that. There is a Hilton hotel just up the road. I would have gone in there, and that would have probably... You know, when you walk into a hotel and you want a room there and then, that is the most expensive time to get a room, right? If you book in advance, it's generally okay. But if you go into a hotel and you want that room there and then, it probably costs you 200 quid. It really would. And you've got to be out at 10 in the morning. You don't get any extra time in bed just because you've got there late. I don't think so, anyway. And I had visions of me doing it, and I kept ringing, and I kept this guy. He must have had about 40 or 50 missed calls on his phone. And then I gave up, and blow me down. 2 minutes later, he rung back and said, oh, I need my keys. And he said, well, what time will you be here? He said, about 12 o'clock. I said, well, I'm about an hour away now. He said, I'm going to go back to bed. I'll put them somewhere. So he put them somewhere. I got to his house, and the keys were indeed where he said they were. And he doesn't live far from here, like in the car, 5 minutes. 5 minutes in the car, 20 to 25 minutes walk. And it's a nice walk up there, actually. Although not today. It's cold out there today. I haven't been out yet. Oh, hang on, I've got... I haven't actually been out yet, so I've still got that to do to... collected the keys, got back in my house, and that's it. I had some... on the way here, I was so wound up about these keys that I'm afraid I stopped at a BP garage and purchased a cheese ploughman sandwich and two bags of crisps and a bar of chocolate, but I haven't eaten them all. I'm glad to say I haven't eaten them all. This is doing no good for my weight, is it? Eating all this old rubbish. I'll come back to your messages in a minute, boys and girls, okay? and the queue was a mile long in this BP garage. It's the BP garage on the A30. There's several routes I can take home. My preferred route is actually not on the motorway. It's on this road called the A30. So you come off... You come out of London, you go round the M25, and you come off at the A30, go around this roundabout, and it's just a nice journey, even at night, because you've come away from the hustle and bustle of London. The motorway as well. You're not on the motorway. And it's just a nice drive. You've got trees on that either side. And you go through some lovely places. Sunningdale, which is just a lovely little place. Sunningdale, Ascot. I go through Ascot. And then home. And I prefer that route. Well, on this route is a BP garage. There's only one. And it's open. You can walk in. Isn't that wonderful? You can walk into this petrol garage. There's one thing I hate, and that's having to use the little hole in the wall that some of these garages... Because obviously, some, I suppose in some places, it's quite dangerous to have that thing open all the time. Not in Egham, dear. No, not in Egham, where this one is. And you can walk in, and you can browse. They've got a Marks and Spencers thing there, so you can get a few bits of shopping if you've run out of things. And you go back and then just pay. And there was a queue a mile long in there. Policeman in there. There was a policeman in there. I thought he was about 10 years old, this policeman. My word. How young was he? He must have just come out of school. And he was a proper policeman. You know, he had all the uniform and the wireless thing on the radio thing there. The handcuffs there. He had it all. He was about 15 years old, I'm telling you, this policeman. And I said, blimey, they've got a queue in here a mile long. And he just smiled. And it was. I don't know how the queue built up. So I ordered a cup of tea in there as well. And I thought I'd drink that. And then I went to Ron's and got my keys. So I've come back in. I've had another cup of tea while I'm here. And I put a little bit of telly on. And I've taken my three bags out of the car. Couldn't even put the car in the garage, could I? No, dear. I've lost all the keys. Now, on my mate doesn't have a full set of my keys. He's got like the front door. That's it, the front door. The front door and the front gate. That's all he's got. He hasn't got the garage keys or anything. So I've left the car outside. Now, actually, we don't have trouble really around here with people breaking into cars, but it could happen. Most people, they use their garages to sort of just shove things in, don't they? Old cities, and they've got carriages full of crap. That this stuff is never going to come out of that garage. I bet you've got one, haven't you? Anyone got a garage? Is it full of rubbish? And how long's it all been there? Years, I suppose. That stuff is never going to be used. I'm telling you now, it will absolutely never be used. I got back indoors, got my cup of tea, and I've now got my bags in front of me. I'll have one more look in these bags. So I emptied the bag with the mixer and the wire, the sound mixer. It's only a very small sound mixer. Not in there. There's only a couple of items in there. I emptied the bag which holds the quiz sheets and the pens and things like that. Not much in that bag. Nothing in there. Then I started emptying the computer bag, which always holds, where I always put my keys in. I never don't put my keys in there. And while I'm doing this, I'm thinking, if my keys are not in here, I'm going to think to myself that I've gone mad because I'm absolutely positive I put them in. So I've taken out the laptop, not under there. I've taken the wires out of one side. I've taken the wires out of another side. I've started emptying the pockets and I put my hand in and I'm feeling around. Can't feel any keys. I pulled out a load of stuff, put it on the floor. Another pocket, pulled out a load of stuff, can't feel the keys, put it on the floor. Then when I looked on the floor, among all the rubber bands and pens, you've got one of those, haven't you, ladies? You've got a bag with all this stuff in it, with rubbish in it, haven't you? There they are, my keys. And I knew they were in that bag. And yet, four or five times in the pub and in the car, I could not find those keys. And that is actually a similar thing has happened before. But I did it at the pub. And if you can't find your keys, what you've got to do, and ladies, I'm sure you're the same with your handbags, what you've got to do is tip up that bag and empty everything out of it, and I bet they've got caught up in something else. So there we are. That is the story of the lost and found keys. Hooray! Hooray! Yeah, hooray. Have you ever lost keys? Have you ever lost keys? Maybe you didn't find them. Do tell me. I've got a phone line open, but it's not open for long because I don't want to be here all day today, my friends. We did an hour and a half the other night, didn't we? Which was nice, but I just haven't got the time to do an hour and a half today. So if you want to call in, you can do. Phone numbers come up there. If you're watching the show live, the phone number will be up there. If you're watching a recording of the show, the phone number's not there because obviously you can't call in. I won't be here. 020-8144-3477 is my call-in number. It's a local London number, boys and girls. All right, a local London number, 020 01443477 is the phone number. If you've got Skype, you can Skype in as well. My Skype username is all one word, United Kingdom Talk. Have you ever lost your keys? Did you find them? Or if you didn't, what did you do? 020-8144-3477. Only for 10 minutes or so we've got that open, okay? Good morning to Warren. Oh, you're with us again today, Warren. Which part of the world are you from? Are you still on British Airways? I think you're, or is it, I'm sure you're on Airways, aren't you? British Airways. Good morning, Warren. Good morning to Adam, who said, I thought, oh, we got a call coming in there. Just a second now. Oh my God, two calls. I can only do one. Oh, it's going to be that one. Hello, who's calling in, please?
Non-Irish Mary, all the way from Ireland.
Oh, good morning to non-Irish Mary from Ireland. If you ever go across the sea to Ireland...
Don't lose your keys.
Oh, your Mary. I was in... Well, actually, I wasn't too bad, to be honest. The main thing is I had my car key.
Yeah.
So I could get home. I could drive to the Hilton Hotel just up the road, stay there until we woke up in the morning. So I wasn't that too... You know what's worse than that? Losing your phone now. Because everything's on your phone, isn't it?
Yeah. My neighbour, David, went swimming in Bournemouth the other day. And for some strange reason, he had his phone in his pocket.
In the swimming pool?
No, in the sea.
In the sea in January?
Yeah, he's a bit weird.
He wants his head seen to, doesn't he? Oh dear, I'm not having any of that.
A couple of weeks ago, I lost my glasses in Central.
Oh, yes, I remember that. Did you find them again?
In the lining of my coat.
Oh. You know what? You want to buy yourself a decent coat. You will stop. You will keep buying that cheap stuff, my darling. If you spend a little bit more money on your stuff, the lining won't tear. Have you ever lost keys, Mary?
Sorry?
Have you ever lost keys?
No.
You've never lost keys, no.
I'm very responsible. You know, when it comes to the palace, I have to make sure.
I have once. I've got to tell you, I have once. And I don't mind sharing this experience with you. It was about 20 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And I'd been out all night. I'd been out at a rave at Turnmills. You know Turnmills, don't you?
Still going?
No, it's not. They knocked it down and I think it's the offices now. Anyway, I'd been to Turnhills and I'd got back here and I could not find my keys anyway, and it was off my head. I was completely off my head. And I called out this key bloke at, I don't know, 7 o'clock in the morning when I got back or something like that, and he had to drill out the locks. And then, of course, they don't go away. You've then got to give them proof that it is your house. Because I suppose, really, a burglar could do that, couldn't they?
Oh, yeah.
When you think about it.
Show up and say, I'm locked out of my house.
Yeah.
The place out.
Yeah, so I did get in the end, but it's the worst thing, losing your keys like that and not being able to...
Yeah,
I mean, the amount of
keys and phones.
Yeah, the amount of keys.
Do a backup again on my computer.
Oh, yes, you've got to do that.
This morning.
You've got to do that. You need the old external hard drive to back everything up on.
Yeah, I have one of those yokes, yeah. What's it called? A passport.
Oh, you've got the little blue one.
No, it's not this.
Is it blue or red?
No, it's silver.
Silver. Oh, you've got, and it's a little square thing, isn't it?
It's sort of rectangular.
Oh, maybe not then. That
and
sounds like a different one.
Stick it in the side of the baffle.
I've actually got several external hard drives that I use to back stuff up on. Very, very. So many people don't do that, and you lose everything. Your entire life can be lost in the space of a few seconds if you don't do that.
And like with my kids doing their essays for uni and stuff.
Yeah.
If something goes wrong.
Yes.
It's like, oh my God, I've lost three.
Oh yeah,
work.
Yeah.
No, all I'd lose is videos and pictures, really.
Video? Oh, you've not got any of those nasty pictures on your phone,
no,
have you,
no,
Mary?
No.
Oh, dear, well, I thought it was only the
really
youngsters that sent those
stuff up.
I thought it was only the youngsters that sent each other that sort of thing, dear. I'm going to have to terminate that call. You've really brought down the whole tone of this programme today, Mary.
I hope you have a lovely day.
You keep looking at those pictures, then. Be very careful, you go blind.
I hope you don't get snowed in wherever you are.
Cheerio, Mary.
All right, ta-da, love. God
Thank
bless.
You, Mary. Bye-bye, my darling. There's non-Irish Mary from Ireland, boys and girls. We can do another call if you want, 0208 144 3477. Warren says, yes, indeed, he is on British Airways. Glad to hear that you're on a decent, the world's most popular airline. Just a moment. Let me just type that in there. Add Mary there so I know she's there. Oh, have I done that wrong? Just a minute. Oh, another call coming in. It's Adam the plumber. And good morning, Adam. How are you?
Good morning, Chris. How are you?
I'm very well. I'm happy to be indoors. I must say.
So am I.
I nearly slept in the car last night.
I heard. I'm indoors as well today.
Oh, what, are you off today?
Well, yeah, because there's no work for me.
Oh.
Nobody's using the train stations because they're on strike,
yes,
aren't they, I believe.
Yeah. Yeah, no one's blocking up those toilets today, are they?
Nobody's blocking up those toilets. I can't get my hands dirty today.
Oh, God.
So I've had to resort to phoning you instead.
Had you ever thought about wearing gloves when you're unblocking those toilets or what?
Well, you know, it's expensive. Gloves are expensive.
Well, you can get some of those little rubber thing. Mind you, some of the cheap ones are just a waste of time. You've only got to accidentally catch them on something and the thing's ripped to bits anyway, don't they?
Well, that's what I was told by one of the companies that I used to work for. You've got to look after your disposable gloves because they cost £5 a box. Seriously.
Have you ever lost your keys? You have.
The van keys.
Oh, my word.
Yep.
Were you at home or out somewhere?
No, I was at home and okay. I tidied up the van and sorted it out and I had a private job to do and obviously not allowed to use the company vehicle for doing my private work. So I loaded all my tools in the car, off I drove and thought, oh, I need to go back and get a screwdriver sort of thing. So drove back sort of thing, pulled up, thought, right, keys. Looked in my pocket, weren't there. And also looked in the glove box, and I just searched the whole car. I almost took all my clothes off looking for the keys, sort of thing.
Oh, it's not a nice sight, is it, Adam?
It's not, I know. You've seen it many a time. Oh, yes. Anyway, took all the bits out of my pocket, emptied out my tool bag all over the floor. Thought, oh, no, what am I going to do? Because there's only one key for the van. So I'm panicking by this point, and I'm looking around, and I thought, right, we're going to have to switch the vans open. So I've checked all the doors, know it's definitely locked and everything else, and looked everywhere, couldn't find them anywhere. So I thought, oh, I'm going to have to call somebody in a minute. Anyway, I'm sort of thought, oh, God, what am I going to do? Sort of put my head on the bonnet of the van in despair. As I've looked up there, they are sitting on the windowsill.
On the windowsill, yeah.
And they'd been there for about 20 minutes, and I thought, oh, my God, if anybody got hold of them, they could have driven off in the van or anything.
Exactly. You could have been abducted, and terrible things could have happened to you.
Well, one can dream, can't you?
I might do all that. I might try that later myself. But it's the most obvious place, isn't it? You know, that's just awful. Look, not being able to find your keys. At least you were able to get somewhere because you were there, weren't you?
Mm-hmm. Indeed, yes. Yeah, God. That's right. It was amusing. But there you go. What can you do?
Awful. I'm glad I found mine. You know, it costs enough money to call out a locksmith anyway, but to call them out at like 2 o'clock in the morning, you've got to be looking at £300 or £400 now.
Oh, easily. Well, unless of course you call Adam the Plumber Plumbing and Maintenance Service to come out
Don't tell me you do keys as well. You do everything, don't you? Can you drill out a lock?
My full company name now is Adam the Plumber Plumbing and Maintenance Services.
Right. Okay.
And I use a couple of. I'm starting to build my website.
I thought you were going to say aliases then.
No. And I also use a couple of social apps to advertise on. Let's say.
Yes.
I won't name them.
Yes, you can. Of course you can name them. Of course you can. It's not the BBC, yeah. Dear. Not yet. Still waiting for the phone call.
I use Growler.
Who?
Growler.
Growler, what's that?
Like Grindr.
Oh, is that a dating app? What, you advertise your services on there?
Yeah, and well, I've got loads of jobs out of it.
Really? Do you have to do extras as well?
No, it's not. It's purely a professional business.
Just, I often say to people that anyone that I meet, I send them to you for plumbing stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And I say to them, I said, I absolutely guarantee he will not rip you off. Now, can you just explain, right, say I am like someone you don't know, okay?
Mm-hmm.
But I've come to you and I just heard so and so say you do plumbing work. I'm in the London area and I've got a tap that's dripping.
Okay?
Would you just tell us now? So say you're in London, let's not include travelling here, okay?
Yep.
So you're in London, which can be, you know, you could be 2 hours travelling to somewhere. Let's put in there an hour travelling. Okay? Mm-hmm. And a dripping tap. Mm-hmm. And the most common thing, which is the washer, isn't it?
Yeah, that's right.
What are you going to charge me for that?
About £35.
About £35.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and what's the call out?
That's all inclusive. I don't have a call out charge.
So you're not going to charge me a £150 call out?
Nope.
You're going to charge me £35 to drive to my house, change the washer on the tap, and that's it.
Yep. That's it.
All right, there's an example. Now, and I guarantee...
Sorry, go on.
No, actually, no, you know more than me. A plumber, a general plumber who works for... Let's think of that big one. Pimlico Plumbers.
Yep.
Any idea what they'd charge me for that?
Talking £80 plus, I don't imagine.
Minimum of £80, you reckon?
I would have thought so, yeah.
So there you go. Adam the Plumber. If you ever want to know Adam the Plumber... and you can't find him, send me a message and I'll pass on the details for you. Would you like to give us your details? Now, is there a phone number that people standing by, poised, boys and girls? I like that word, poised. Poised with their pens. If you need a plumber and you're in London and the South East, what is the number we should call?
Right, well, you can either look me up on Facebook, Adam the Plumber, Plumbing and Maintenance. That's my Facebook site, so people can see my the work that I have done. And if they want to contact me, it's 07-464-429-067. So that's 07-464-429-067.
If you don't mind me saying, that wasn't done with much flair.
Oh, sorry. Okay, let me try again, shall we? Okay, so if you need Adam the Plumber, Plumbing and Maintenance Services... You must call me straight away on 07-464-429-067. I repeat, 07-464-429-067 for all your plumbing and maintenance needs throughout London and the South East.
Well, that's a bit better, but I feel you need a jingle.
Yes,
you need a jingle.
I need to employ the professionalism of a jingle expert. Where's Ray Reynolds' number when you need it?
Ray Reynolds? What do you mean, Ray Reynolds?
No.
Call Adam the Plumber. 07-464-429-067. Yeah. And
that's
I think
it. We need you to do my jingle. That's your challenge for the day.
And what we have to do is do a little film for your television adverts with scantily clad people. Not us. We're doing the singing. You know, like some of the stars. Not the big proper stars, but sometimes they were singing on a stage and there would be someone else behind the curtains actually doing the singing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it'd be a bit like that. Where are we doing the singing? And we'll have scantily clad young people on the stage. Doing the dancing and all that, Adam.
Excellent.
Thanks very much for calling in, Adam. A pleasure as always, sir.
Cheers. And you, Chris. Thanks.
Cheerio now. Adam the Plumber. Yeah, that's who you want. That's who you want to fix your bits and pieces. Let's do some more messages. Mary's, non-Irish Mary from Ireland, says, nice one, Adam. I'll use you next time I'm dripping. Oh, dear. I've got a vision in my head now. Please, Mary. Thank you. Incidentally, Warren, I hope you're enjoying this more than the James O'Brien show. I think I could be a good replacement for James O'Brien, but we can't do politics. I'm not intelligent enough to do politics. Elaine says, lunch hour over, I'm afraid. Have fun, everyone. Enjoy your day back at work, Elaine, OK? Danny says, I lost my keys to the pub I was running. Then I had a call from my boss and he said, I've got them in his pocket. I'd given him them the night before. My heart sank. I'm sure it did. Good morning to Joan, who's with us this morning. Kiki D says, I'm glad you found them. I'm glad as well, Kiki D. And good morning to Richard Morris. Oh, my favourite Jewish friend. Good morning, Richard. Hope you're doing well. Thank you for joining us tonight. How lovely for you. This morning, how lovely. We're not usually here live first thing in the morning. It's very unusual. We'll just finish off a couple of messages, then we'll do the birthdays, and then I'll have to go because it's time for me to go swimming, boys and girls. I need to get up to that swimming pool. Got to say good morning to Ray Hornsby, who joins us as well for the first time this morning. Good morning, Ray. Here come today's birthdays, and I hope... what was I going to do then? Just a minute, I've forgotten something. Messages from yesterday's show that I haven't read out. I do beg your pardon. I forgot to do the messages yesterday, didn't I? Sarita. Good morning to Sarita today, who says, I'm so glad Katie the cat is still doing okay. Give her a hug from me. Your show always puts a smile on my face. She gets lots of hugs. I always try and make a little bit of a fuss with her every time I go in and out of the kitchen, because that's where she lives, in her little warm bed in the kitchen that she lives. She hasn't been toilet for 24 hours. I'm a bit concerned about that. Usually there's a mess somewhere, but since I started telling you, there isn't any. So I hope she's not going to explode. Oh, that'd be a terrible mess, wouldn't it? Good morning to David, who's now the big 4-0. Good morning, David. Wendy says, lovely to hear Matt Martins at the end of the show yesterday. So glad he phoned. Keep wearing that cross, Matt. Absolutely. Joanne says, I missed you live again. I get the time messed up. Oh, well, not necessarily. Remember, the live shows are never scheduled. I just do them as and when. You know, if I've got a few, some spare time, that's when I do them, OK? I think that's about it. Oh, Ray Reynolds says, that was a great show yesterday, Chris. The time just flew by. Thanks to Danny from Manchester for the mention. I'm 69 now and was a party DJ for 35 years. I gave up being a DJ about 8 years ago. I don't miss it at all, as the club music scene took over, even at weddings eventually. So it was good to have those best years of family entertainment, and it was good to be at the right place in the right time. I'm also a member of the George Formby Society and can get up on stage and do a bit on the ukulele 4 times a year in Blackpool. And I love a karaoke night hosted by star performer Chris Reardon. Thank you very much. And Ray also says, I've been watching Take the High Road. Now, you know that's an old Scottish soap thing. That isn't on anymore. It finished years ago. But I used to love the music for it. Now, Ray says it's being repeated on Scottish television, Glasgow and Edinburgh, 4:30 to 5 p.m. You can get it on your Freesat box. And he gives us this list of numbers. So thank you for that, Ray. And actually, when I got home last night, after I found my keys and I couldn't sleep, I was so, I was so worried about these keys, and I found them eventually, fortunately. I thought I'll try that. And I found on my Freesat recorder. Good morning, Antonio. And good morning, Shania. All right. Good morning, you two. I found on my Freesat box, there is in the menu, there is search non-Freesat channels. So I found that, and I indeed found Scottish television on there. So I will be able to watch that. Take the High Road. And I found, boys and girls, you the music. The best part of Take the High Road was the music and the scenery. Here's the theme music. It's so nice. Have a listen to this. Isn't it lovely? La da 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 da. Sing along. That's it. There we are. Take the High Road from Scottish Television. Still available on STV. Today's birthdays then, boys and girls. Let's do today's birthdays. Happy birthdays this morning to Adam Shailes, who's 33 years old today. To Doron Vaisenberg, 45 today. Michelle Carberry. Hello, Michelle. All right, darling. Dan Stedman. To James Darwin. Chris Ireland. Oscar John Ferguson, who's 49 today. And Korin Heller, it says you're 112 today. You don't look 112, but perhaps you've got a really good surgeon. So let's sing the birthday song to you, and then we'll be disappearing, boys and girls. Oh, hang on a minute, just a minute. I'm still playing that Take the High Road there. Birthday time. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Have a lovely birthday, boys and girls. It's Thursday night. I'll be doing a little bit of DJing tonight at the Two Brewers in Clapham. That's from 10 o'clock. Thank you very much for joining me on this Thursday, and we'll have another chat again soon. Have a lovely day. Bye-bye now.